I heard that one of my friends is here. I ain't seen her yet. They said she rode her back in or something, come in from, was eating a funnel cake. Did she ever got through or what? But anyway, I think she's here. If she is, if anybody's seen her, tell her to come on in here. Because I love, the power of God's always here when she's here. Amen. All right, she's here. It's Gospel Granny. Woo! Give her a big hand. It's Gospel Granny. She goes from camp meeting to camp meeting, from youth rally to youth rally, telling young people to stand against the devil, against the wiles of the devil. She's here tonight. It's Gospel Granny. Woo-hoo! All right.
Warning, please do not attempt to perform any of the stunts or activities in this show, as they are dangerous and could lead to serious injury. Video submissions of any kind are not accepted by MTV or the producers.
Get away!
Yeah, yeah, yeah!
Oh, my God! You all right?
Whoa! Woo! Turn up!
What a crowd we have here tonight. I'm Rob Dyrdek, and this is Ridiculousness. This is the show that gets you going, but you just don't know where. Here we have my lovely co-host, Chanel West Coast. And as always, Sterling Stilo Brim. These are the mentors that I trust for all of us. Now, tonight, we are doing our show different than any other that we've ever had. Instead of video submissions, we are doing real live stunts.
Woo!
That means you're on national TV.
Yeah.
So if you mess up, no second chance.
Yeah.
Let's bring out our first contestant, Big Doug. Now, he's big, but I don't know if he's big enough to break a concrete wall. Second chance. Well, so much for hard-headed me. Now we have a man who thinks that he can channel anybody. Here he is. What's up, man?
I'm going to try to bring Johnny through. He told me to walk the line, and he'd be with me.
Well, I hear this train coming, it's rolling around the bend, and I ain't seen the sunshine since. I don't know when I've been stuck in Folsom Prison. Time keeps dragging on, and that train keeps rolling.
Woo!
On them sand.
Yeah.
Wow. Sterling, what do you think about this?
That's kind of creepy. Was that really Johnny Cash?
I don't know. I think I heard that from my grandma or something.
Well, moving on. Now we are in the category of diversity. We are all different in many ways, and we need to learn to accept and love each other to bring in diversity. No second chance.
Yep.
Loco Diablo back again. Arrepiéntete,
Jesucristo salva, ni infierno quema, pon tu fe en el Señor Jesucristo, hijo de Dios, de que sea tarde. A loco and his gang. Who's going to win this show today? Gringo? Jesucristo and his gang is going to take over America. We're going to change the American eagle to the American cucaracha! Yeah. Where's that big gringo? Let me get him. I'm going to begin with him.
Wait, man, I don't think that I would do that. Excuse me? I don't think I'd do that.
Oh, yes.
Oh, gosh. Now, we have a 9-year-old that is going to do something that no one in their right mind would do.
What's that?
Well, you're about to find out.
Oh, oh no! Oh, no!
He did it.
Woo!
Whoa. That was nice. Now we are at the Kids Can Do It section of the show. We have a 7-year-old that wants to fight Big Doug.
Bring him out. No second chance.
A rod of correction will drive it far from you. Do you hear me?
Run!
You two babies, come here. Come here, precious. Come here, honey. I want to talk to y'all a minute. Now, I love the babies. Lord Jesus loves the babies, honey. He says, suffer not them little children to come unto me, honey. Listen, boys. Oh, look at you with your little gloves on, honey. You so darling. Now, listen, honey. I know you're good on that little motorbike and all, and I think you need to be jumping for Jesus, honey. I think the Lord will bless you for that. Listen now, he wants you to go down there at that Sunday school, but I got an idea. Right now, there's youth rally going on. Old friend of mine named Danny K. Castle, honey. He's a good old friend. I want you to go talk to him. Tell him you know Granny, honey, and you want to jump for Jesus, okay? Put your little friend on the back of your little motorcycle, and I want y'all to go down there. Is that okay? Y'all do that for me? Because the Lord wants you in his house, honey, to learn about him, okay? All right, you little boys, stand right over there, precious. You. Come here. Come on down here right now. You always talking about fighting, honey. Lord have mercy. Jesus wants peace in your heart, honey. You always stirring the pot.
Yeah.
You know what stirring the pot in the South means? It means you always causing trouble, honey. And I want you to get some Jesus in your heart tonight. Quit stirring the pot. You do that for me?
Okay, señorita.
Okay, honey. Thank you.
Yeah.
You. You right here. Right now. Come here. Listen, honey, I want to talk to you a minute now. Listen, honey, you ain't no more Johnny Cash than I am June Carter, okay? Or Doug, Big Doug there, my mother-in-law, honey. Listen, I'm going to talk to you a minute about what you're doing. You're playing with something. It's called familiar spirits, okay? And that is witchcraft, free. Yeah! That is the devil, yeah! Honey. That's the devil. Now, let me see you smile. Lord, y'all, look at that grin. He needs to be picking and grinning for Jesus, don't he? Okay, honey, you keep that in that mind, okay?
Yeah.
You, come on, Big Doug. I need to talk to you a minute, big boy. Is that your name, Big Doug?
Yes, ma'am.
Big Doug, where are you from?
From New York.
Well, honey, Lord, if you fell down, you'd be halfway home. You're so tall. You know, they say pride goeth before destruction and a haughty spirit before a fall. But let me tell you what they say here in the South, honey. They say the bigger you are, the
harder you fall.
That's right, honey. So I want you to think about that. The only thing I want you falling for is Jesus. You got it?
Yeah.
All right. Thank you, Big. You be thinking about that. Now, where's that little whippersnapper? Come here, whip boy. I'd like to know who your mama is, for one thing. And let me tell you something. I had a problem growing up. Let me tell you what kind of problem it was. It was a drug problem, honey. My mama drugged me to church on Sunday morning. She drugged me to church on Sunday night. And she drugged me to church on Wednesday. And honey, that's the kind of problem y'all need to be having right now. This stuff that y'all are pulling out here, this ain't nothing, honey, but just some ridiculousness, honey. I'm going to tell y'all something. You ain't even going to believe this, what I'm about to tell you, honey.
Yeah.
You're going to die. We all going to die, honey. It ain't if you die, darling. It's when you die. And you know, these kids around here yelling, YOLO, YOLO. And I'm like, Granny's going, YODO, YODO. And y'all know what that means? You only die once, okay? It is appointed a man wants to die. Now, I want y'all to listen to me good after tonight. You ain't getting no second chance, honey. Y'all ain't getting no second chance. You need to listen to Brother Danny and get you something from Jesus, okay?
All right, Gospel Granny. She goes from youth rally to youth rally, from camp meeting to camp meeting, telling young people to stand against the devil. Gospel Granny.
Woo!
Hallelujah. I don't know who planned all that foolishness. But we're going to have a talk after this is over. Was that our piano player, Miss Desi? Did you plan that? That's right. Well, hallelujah. Gospel Granny goes around telling young people to get right with God. Amen? All right. That thing's still up here. I thought I smelt fuel or something. All right, Dax, you're officially the first man ever to jump over a car in church that I know of. Night I got saved, I felt like I could. And he's also the first 9-year-old that jumped over 4 buses a while ago. Amen, wasn't that good? All right. All right, Todd, where you at? Where's Todd? Be ready. It ain't... I'm telling you, them people can't leave them things alone. I'm going to have Todd give his quick testimony for you young people. He's the one that was jumping down there a while ago, and Dax. And he raced professionally when he was a teenager. And I want him to just tell you about it a little bit. And you kids, listen. Listen carefully. What, Lord?
Hey, I'm glad to be here. Hey, You know, I grew up riding. And you know what? At 7 years old, I got my first bike and started riding. And all I wanted to do is ride and have fun. And got took to a racetrack at 12 years old. And I decided right there I wanted to race motorcycles. And started racing motorcycles. On an 80, raced 3 or 4 races, and then broke a bone in my hand, and then a week later broke my leg, and spent some time in the hospital, and mom and dad said no more of that, but I talked them into it when I got healed up, and anyway, grew up riding, and at 13 we started going racing, and started traveling and racing, and I went from the beginner class to intermediate to expert, and at 15 years old, I was racing the A class, and my goal, when I seen that, I said, you know what, when I seen those pro riders ride, I said, man, I want to be like those guys. And at 16, I turned pro, and you know what, that's the only thing that mattered to me. And you know what? You know, I didn't get, when I turned 16, I didn't even care about getting my driver's license. I didn't get my driver's license until I was, I don't know, it's 6 or 8 months later. And, because I just didn't care about that. I wanted to go racing. I had a focus. And you know what? Racing's taught me a lot of things. And I think it seems like sometimes it's missing in this younger generation. You know, in racing, and that's why I want my boy to grow up riding a motorcycle. I want him, and if he don't want to do it, that's fine and great. But you know something that racing taught me, and it's simple. You know what? It's what you put in is what you'll get out. And you know what? This world, that's the way this world is. You know, I didn't grow up in you know, I remember my grandma saying, you want to be a doctor or a lawyer? And I said, no, I don't. I want to ride motorcycles. And you know what? That wasn't cut out for me. And I believe the Lord, I don't believe the Lord has a cookie cutter in heaven and he makes everybody the same. And I'm glad he don't. We'd look real weird in here if we all wore the same color clothes and the same haircut but you know what? I'm glad the Lord he has a plan for everybody here, and it may not be the same. But you know what? The Lord gave me a talent to ride a motorcycle. And you know what? I grew up riding. And you know what? As Reggie said last night, you know, he said that you guys, I relate to that, but you know, Reggie was a superstar. He was on his way. He was making money. He was doing what he loved to do. I mean, he was in Hollywood. He was out there where, you know, all you kids watch MTV and all that stuff. I hope you don't, but if you do, you know, you're seeing that stuff. You see these guys on TV and the movies, and you think, man, them guys have got the life. They got the life. And you know what? I grew up racing, and at 16, I turned pro. I started getting top 10 finishes in Supercross. I started getting on TV and in magazines. And you know, I had a focus and a plan and where I was headed and going. And you know what? I was, as a kid, I woke up and I was living my dream. And you know what? Just like Reggie, he wanted to, as a kid, I'm sure he dreamed of being famous one day and doing that stuff. And you know what? Every kid in this room, you ought to have a dream. You ought to have a plan. And you know what? I only messed up in one thing. I didn't put the Lord first. You know what? I didn't grow up in church. I didn't grow up much in school either, too, but that's another story. I like to tell this, but you know what? I got out of school with honors in the 10th grade. I got out of school with honors. It was an honor for them to see me go. I tell people I went all the way through school. I went right through the front, right out the back. But you know what? This whole world, you know something? All I want to do is race. You know what? If you'll get your priorities right. You know what? Everybody in this room, you think, man, if I just had money, if I had this, if I had that, if I did that. And you know what? The Lord's blessed me way farther. You know what? When I was racing, I was making money and doing my thing, and I walked away from all that. And you know what? It was a service like this. It was at the youth camp. the Lord got a hold of my heart. And you know what? I grew up racing, and that's all I knew and was doing. And man, the Lord got a hold of me. And you know what? I walked away from what I knew and got on path. And you know what? The Lord just took a little time. And you know, everybody wants it now, now, now. You know what? The Lord wants to prove you. I believe that. And you know what? I got right with the Lord, and I put my priorities right. And the Lord's blessed me far greater. And you know what he'll do for you? He'll do the same thing. Hey, it ain't always the easy road, but you know what? If you'll put him first, all that crap that you're dealing with, the things in your life, and you know what? As a young kid, you ain't got a lot of junk. But the older you get, you're going to get more stuff, and you know what? You're going to have to deal with it. You're going to have to make decisions. You better put the Lord first. And you know what? You ain't got to get it all figured out either. I didn't have it all figured out, but you know what? The Lord, I pray every day, Lord, guide my path. And the Lord's blessed my life, and man, I put him first, and man, I've jumped all over the United States for people and done what I love to do and got to go to church while I was doing it. And you know what? The Lord could use Dax way greater. And you know what? He can use you guys too. Social media and all that stuff. You know what? You guys have an opportunity, just like Dax. And you got an opportunity to be a witness for the Lord. And you got an opportunity to stand for what's right. And I just thank the Lord for saving me. And man, he's blessed my life. And man, the secret to this thing is just put him first. And man, I got it figured out a long time ago. And you know what the good news is? One service, man, one service. You know what? Here's the good news tonight. You ready to hear it? The preacher, they might disagree with me, but I believe they would. But here, they'd agree. But here's the thing: you get it one time right, you get it in here right, you'll be fixed from now on.
Man.
And you know what? I'm still here today because one service.
That's right.
One service. I took it serious tonight, and the Lord got a hold of my heart. Man, it could be your night tonight. One service changed my life. And you know what? If I never went to church again, and I don't have that plan, but if I did, if I never darkened the door again, you know what? I got the goods in me, and I know the right, and I know where the peace comes from, and I know what to do. But the good news is, man, you get it right, and you'll want to come to church. And I thank the Lord for saving me. Thank him for blessing me and all he's done, man. And what an opportunity, man. He's blessed my life, my girls. One more thing. If it wasn't for my wife, you know what? If it wasn't for her doing right, I wouldn't be here tonight. And you know what? I wouldn't trade it for the world. And I'll fight and kill you for her. How about that? But you know what? If it wasn't for her and you girls, if you'll stay right with the Lord, man, the Lord will bless you with a guy. And you know what? I didn't deserve her. But he's been good to me. And you know what? I'm going to take care of her. So do what you're supposed to do, and Lord, to put do he'll do what he's supposed to do. He'll add it on there. Thank you, guys.
Amen. Good job. Amen.
Amen. Come on, Brother Jason. Let's stand and sing Victory in Jesus. If you got the victory tonight, you sing it out real big and real loud.
All right, amen. Thank God I heard an old story one day. Changed my life, amen. Amen. Let's sing it tonight. Amen. Turn down a little bit if you want to. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's sing it tonight. You'll catch on right here, this crowd. You know what to do. I heard an old, old story. Monitor. Came from glory. How he gave his life on Calvary. Yeah. To save a wretch like me. I heard about his groaning. Oh, of his precious blood to atoning. Then I read. Oh, it sounds good. Turn it up now. Let's hear it all over Morganton. Oh, victory in Jesus. He's my Savior forever. He sought me. Get ready now. With his redeeming
precious blood.
He loved me, yeah. Y'all do that. And all my love is due him. He plunged me to victory beneath the... Thank God, amen. We're going to sing, I heard about his healing, of his cleansing power. Okay, on the second. I heard about his healing, of his cleansing power revealing. How he made the lame to walk again. And cause the blind to see. Sing it now. And then I cried, dear Jesus, yes, my old broken spirit. And somehow Jesus came and brought to. Yes, he did. Sing that chorus now. Oh, victory in Jesus. Amen. My Savior forever. He sought me and he bought me with his redeeming blood. Let's get it. I knew him and all my love is to him. He plunged. All right, amen. All right, we're going to sing this last one. Thank God I heard about a mansion. And then we're going to drop out on the chorus. I heard about a mansion he has built for me in glory. Sing it loud. And I heard about the streets of gold beyond the crystal sea. About the angels singing and the old redemption story. And some sweet day I'll sing up there. Amen. All right. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and he bought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me, yeah, I knew. And all my love is to him. He plunged me to victory beneath the crimson flood. What's that?
Amen. You can be seated. You can be seated.
Okay.
Amen.
All right. Need everybody to get your seat now. Tonight. Everybody get your seat, please. Please, y'all. Everybody get a seat. Good. I want you to take your Bibles now. In this time when we've been praying for many, many months, ever since this time last year. The message I bring tonight come on my heart about 3 months ago. And I want you to listen to every word I say. Everything I'm going to show you tonight and tell you has been prayed over, fasted over. And there's no doubt in our mind tonight that God brought this big gathering of people together this evening. Hebrews chapter 9. Take your Bibles tonight. The book of Hebrews chapter number 9. thank you for the work you've done in bringing all these young people here tonight. This is no doubt the biggest crowd of young people in this county gathered for anything this evening. Hebrews chapter number 9. The famous verse that we all know, it's been quoted here tonight, is verse 27. And as it is appointed unto men once to die, but after this, the judgment. According to that verse, you only have one life. One life. My message tonight is titled, No Second Chance. Now, by way of introduction this evening, I want to say God gives us all a chance. We all got a chance. You've got a chance in life. There's nobody you can blame for the mess you're in. There's nobody you can say, well, they made me get like this or they made me sin. We all got a chance. You can live right or you can mess up your life. And I want to say also that there are some things in life with which, thank God, we get many chances. God, there's many in the Bible that God give a second chance and a third and a fourth and a fifth and a sixth. The story of Jonah, when Jonah wouldn't go preach and then God give him another chance. It said the word of the Lord came unto Jonah the second time. And he went and preached and done God's word. Thank the Lord for that. Peter, after he had denied the Lord, and the Lord still used him to preach that great sermon on the day of Pentecost, wherein 3,000 people were saved. David, after, and many, many others, after they had got out of God's will, God gave them another chance. There are some things like that. But boys and girls, teenagers tonight, there are some things for which me and you don't get a second chance. Just one chance. Tonight, I want to talk to you about that just a little bit. When you're young, you don't realize how fast you grow up. Isn't that true, adults? I remember when I was little, it seemed like time just went so slow. And Christmas, for example, would seem like it took forever to get Christmas. Finally came. The older you get, the more you realize you only get one chance. No second chance going to school. I went through school, and you start out kindergarten, first grade, and you go all the way through high school. One day you're sitting on the bus at about third or fourth grade, rode the school bus like I did, and you hear older boys or girls using dirty words and bad language. The first time you hear it, you think, that's bad. Then you see the other kids laugh. And when they laugh, you think, wow, that must be cool. So you say a cuss word so that they'll think you're cool. Isn't that right? That's what we call peer pressure. Your peers are the people that you grow up, that grows up around you, your equals around you. Then you begin to get disrespectful. One day you heard somebody tell a dirty joke, probably on the school bus or probably at school. And you thought, wow, they thought that was funny. If I do it, they'll think I'm funny. And the next thing you know, you're telling dirty stories. Or you're telling lies to your parents. You thought that's the way I'd get attention. When it really comes right down to it, most young people, that's what they really want, attention. You know, when you walk in and you got a purple mohawk and a baby diaper pin stuck in your nose, what you're really saying is, will somebody please look at me? And starving for somebody to give you some attention. That's the truth. And I'm not fussing at you. I mean, it's human nature for us to want other people to love us or like us or to appreciate us. Did you realize in this country this evening that most teenagers going to high school, all they think about is being popular, being accepted, dating, who likes who, when do I get my license, what kind of car will I get, where will I go, who will go with me, will I get to go here? Well, I don't like her, I do like her, she don't like me, she don't like my friend. That's their whole life. And you need to realize that second grade, third grade, fourth grade, fifth grade, sixth grade, it goes by fast and you don't get a second chance. You're only young one time. When I was in school, there's probably some of you here tonight, maybe that went to school. I know some of you maybe not the same school, but same time that I did, and remember me, and I remember you, back when we were in junior high, in high school. There was a young man went to our school that people treated bad. You talk about bullying. People, everybody in the class just about was mean to that boy. And I wasn't saved, but I remember joining in with them guys and poking fun at that boy. And I felt bad about it then. I wasn't even saved. But I thought, man, we ought not to treat that guy like that. But all of y'all know, when you're in school, kids can be mighty mean and cruel to others. You hear a lot about bullying nowadays and bullying. And I look back now and I think, why did we treat that boy like that? He got killed in a car wreck about a year after we graduated. You see, I can't go back and be nice to him. I only got one chance when I was coming up. And you are too, y'all. Ever out, you're living your life right now. I mean, that's it. You're not going to get to go back and say, well, wait a minute, I messed up. Make me back 7, 8, 9, 10 so I can be better at school. One chance. One chance. And it don't matter if you're the most popular kid in school. It don't matter if all the cool kids invite you over. That don't matter. Look, tell them, older people, 15 months after you graduate, you won't even know where most of them people are, and you'll never see most of them again, and you messed up, some of you, your whole life. I know boys right now that are on drugs, been in prison. I know some that's been killed in car accidents because they literally broke their neck trying to please kids at school, and the kids at school couldn't care less about them. They don't care about you. I'm telling you, you only get one chance in school. They want to join a gang. They want to be popular. They want to say something or do something that they want to put up a sign. Like we was talking about the bumper stickers a while ago. The bumper sticker. You say, there's no way. Listen, if you're a teenager, put a bumper sticker on your car. Be a witness for the Lord Jesus Christ. If them nuts can go around looking like they look, and put on their car, surely we ought not to be ashamed to be a witness for the Lord Jesus Christ. I read some the other day. Steve, you might use for an example. Somebody made one that said, down in South Carolina, somebody made one that said, the government making sin legal does not make it right. Amen? Making sin legal don't make it right. Somebody else it's just in South Carolina, put on their sign, church sign, whoever stole our air conditioners, keep one. It's hot where you're going. But I like this one somebody made. Said, the rapture, real separation of church and state. How about that? Amen, brother. I'm going to tell you, they talk about separation of church and state. God's going to separate us one of these days. Well, when you're at school, you only get one chance. Tonight, we'll illustrate that truth by letting you see a young lady at school. Maybe you can see yourself, girls, in the life of this young lady. Maybe you can see yourself at school.
Bags are packed in.
Gosh, study, Jessica. Do your homework, Jessica. That's all I ever hear. It's so lame.
Jessica, I really wish that you would focus on school and try your hardest.
Listen, I've heard it and heard it. I'm just ready to get out of this prison. Friday's coming, and I'm planning to party.
Jessica.
Bye, Felicia.
Maybe you saw yourself there. I'm going to tell you, kids, the Bible said it's appointed a man once to die. The furthest thing from that girl's mind is dying. All she can think of is my friends, I'll party, I'm going to live like I want to live, I'm going to do what I want to do, I'm going to go where I want to go, I'm going to do with my life what I want to do with it. And God says you don't get a second chance. I can take you places tonight where you would have wished to God that you'd have had another chance. You're going to wish to God one day that you'd have had another chance. You're going to wish to God one day that you say, Lord, I wish I'd have done better at school. And just because you're a Christian does not mean that we get special privileges or anything like that. We ought to do the best. We ought to be more respectful to our teachers. We ought to be more respectful to the police. We ought to do more respectful and honor God with our lives. Amen? But secondly, you don't get a second chance at home. Here's where the devil's got his guns pointed. There's many Bible illustrations of a tore up home. Esau, who sold his birthright for a mess of pottage. And Esau didn't realize that he was losing his chance. Absalom, who rebelled against his daddy, and he got left out and wound up hanging by his head in that oak and had those darts thrust through his chest. Young people tonight, there's thousands and thousands and thousands your age, in rehab, in the funeral home, in a place where their mind's messed up. I'm thinking right now of a boy I went to school with. His daddy was a preacher. His daddy pastored a church in our community. That boy got messed up on drugs. I don't know what all he got on. He'd taken this, he'd take anything, wanted to stay high all the time. And the last I heard about him, he was in an institution somewhere and didn't even know his name. He couldn't even talk. He didn't know where he was at. Are y'all girls listening? Are you listening to me? Are you hearing me tonight? That could be you. You don't get a second chance. You don't get a second chance to respect your parents. You don't get a second chance to honor thy father and thy mother, that thy days may be long upon the earth. When I see one of the kids at our church and they're disrespecting their parents, you know what I tell them? I said, do you want to die young? And they say, no. And I said, you better honor your father and your mother. You may not always agree with what they say. You may not always like what they do. You may not always appreciate them. But I tell you what you better do. You better honor your father and your mother. I'm telling you, our homes are in a mess. And by the way, while I'm talking to the young people, mamas and daddies, you listen. We can't expect our kids to do right when daddy can't even be found. And they don't know where daddy is and don't know what he's doing. And mama has a different boyfriend every other weekend or some yahoo she met on the internet somewhere and don't even come up and you don't even know who's going to come home and who's going to be there. We can't expect our kids to do right. You know what this generation's suffering for? It's not just illegitimate children. It's illegitimate parents. Our homes. Nothing comes out of Hollywood that'll push your kid toward God or holiness or the Bible. They have a show called 16 and Pregnant, and they make these girls, and they literally make stars, TV stars out of girls who have went and broke God's word. And now they're a celebrity. And in one high school I read about not long ago, there was about 15 teenage girls all banded together to see who could get pregnant first. And they all, I'm going to tell you something tonight, you only get one chance. You mess up, you can't go back. After you cross that line, you can't go back. One chance, kids, one chance. You better get it right, because there's no second chance of growing up in life. 750,000 teenage girls will give birth to a baby this year, and 2 out of 3 of them won't graduate high school, and 80% of them will raise kids on welfare to be a repeat for the next generation. Teenage pregnancy cost $7 billion a year. 1 out of 3 teenage girls in this country winds up getting pregnant. You say, well, Brother Danny, my boyfriend, he's so cute, and all the other, one girl said, well, he's got a six pack. Well, in a few years, he'll have the whole case. You better look out. Amen. You say, boy, he's got them pearly whites. What are you going to do in a few years when he takes them out at night and puts them in a cup? You say he's got that long bushy hair. In a few years he'll be hanging on the bedpost at night before you go to sleep. You better take more than just a six pack. Go see the kids in jail. Go see how bad they wish they had another chance. I've seen them laying in the floor and couldn't even hardly turn over. They're so drunk they could not roll over. I've seen them where they couldn't look in the eyes, where they said, I'll do what I want to. I'll smoke it. I'll shoot it. I'll snort it. I'll do it. Let me tell you something. You don't have a second chance. This world's wicked. This world's wicked. They put on a sign not long ago. Said, Jesus had 2 dads, and he turned out all right. You think his world ain't wicked? Jesus didn't have 2 dads. He had 1. That is, unless you got the NIV, and in Luke 2:33, and your NIV had another one besides God. But your Bible said God was his father. Britney Spears' little sister gets pregnant, and it makes headline news. A preacher was at a school not too long ago, and they had an assembly, and the principal pointed out 2 girls, and he said, you see them 2 girls right there? They were in junior high. He said, their babies will be starting school when they graduate. Today we're living in. Go see the kids in jail. I heard about a young man, and he didn't want to do what his mama said. And he wanted to go to a rock concert really, really bad. And his mom said, no, you're not going. He said, I'm going, I don't care what you say. She said, I'm telling you, you're not leaving this house. Wasn't going to let him have the car. He got mad, a spirit came on him. That's what our kids don't understand. I ain't got time to preach on all that, but a spirit comes through that music. And that boy went in his room, had put his headphones on in the bed like this, and those spirits were talking to him. He opened up the drawer, of the dresser drawer, got his daddy's pistol. He went in the living room where his mom was sitting, put the gun to her behind her head, blew his mom's brains out. Because she wouldn't let him go to a concert. Obviously, the neighbors found out. They called the police. They come and arrested that boy. Took him, 16 years old. And took him down to the jail. They take him in that little room. And they arraign him. They question him and drill him and try to get him to confess. And they put him in that little room. And they said, you did it, didn't you? You did it. He said, yeah, I did it. And they said they put him in a cell. And somebody called a preacher. And his preacher came down there. And they said before he got down the hall, he could hear that boy screaming, why can't I go back? Why can't I go back? Mom, Mama, I didn't mean to. Why can't we just go back? Why can't, guess what? There ain't no chance again of doing that over again. No second chance. He couldn't call Mama back. I'm warning you tonight. These kids your age right here tonight, sitting in jail, that ain't going to get another chance. Ain't going to get another chance. It's no joke. We're going to look tonight and see that same girl at home.
Jessica, get what? That thing out of your face and listen to what I have to say. I am sick and tired of this attitude. I don't even know where it comes from.
You know what? The truth is, all the girls my age already have their own car.
I don't even want to hear
well,
about
so
having
stupid.
A car.
I don't get to
the
do
more
anything.
I do for you,
no,
the less you,
you
appreciate it.
All
I am
do
sick
is
and tired of what you're doing. You're going to respect what
no,
I have to
I'm
say.
Not. What if...
You may laugh tonight, but I'm telling you, you'd be shocked at the people sitting in this room right here tonight. That have stuff like that in their home. Home sweet home has turned into hell on earth for many of these young people. That's why I warn you parents. Make sure they get hold of God at home. But then you say, preacher, what that girl needs is to be raised in church. Oh, wait a minute. Them people go to church. Them people go to church. I've been pastoring a church since I was just turned 23. I found out church people many times have the very same problems other people have in many, many cases. The devil fights every single home here tonight. Some of you have been in church since before you were born. You don't get no second chance to go to Bible school when you were 6 years old. You don't get no second chance to take that Bible and read it when they give you one when you're a little kid. You don't get a second chance to go and learn that Bible verse your Sunday school teacher told everybody to learn. You don't get a second chance to learn that song that the kids' choir is going to be singing next Sunday morning. All you little boys and little girls, I tell my daughters, I tell Corey, the one who's up here quoting that stuff a while ago, get little Gage, I say, pump it into him, pump it into him, pump it into him, pump it into it. I tell Carrie, take them kids, I said, put the word of God in them, put it in them, put it in them. They're going out into a world that hates God. They're against everything, men, you believe. You better, hey, parents, you better get them in every church service you can possibly get it in them, because you don't get no second chance. Todd mentioned a minute ago about one service. I'm a believer in that. One service changed my life. I wouldn't even be here tonight if I hadn't went to revival at Nebo Baptist Church one night and got saved by the grace of God. One night. You don't get a second chance. That revival will never happen again. This youth rally will never happen again. If you don't get it tonight, you ain't going to get this over again. You say, we'll have it again next year. Maybe we will, maybe we won't. But it won't be this. It won't be this spirit. It won't be this song. It won't be this sermon. You only get one chance. One chance. One chance at the house of God. Let me tell you what you better do. You better turn that cell phone off and lay that thing down beside you and open up a King James Bible and listen to the man of God preach every Sunday morning, because you ain't going to get no second chance. You wouldn't listen. They did a survey recently among 18,000 high school students. 16,000 could not name three Old Testament prophets. Could you? Three Old Testament prophets. 12,000 could not name the four Gospels. You know the four Gospels? Matthew, Mark, Luke, John. 10,000 could not name three of the 12 disciples out of 18,000 teenagers. They thought Esau wrote fables and sold his copyright for a mess of potash. They said Moses built the ark. They said Brutus betrayed Jesus. They didn't know who Herod was. They didn't know who Pilate was. They didn't know who John the Baptist was. You know why? Because they wouldn't listen at the house of God. Listen, if I'm at church and I'm listening to a preacher and somebody tugs at me and says, Brother Danny, look, Brother Danny, I don't even look at them. You say, what if I get a text? I'm giving you a text right here tonight. And you ain't got no text more important than what you're hearing right here this evening. Amen? I'm going to tell you something, brother. You hear me tonight, brother. You listen to what I'm saying. I mean, God don't have a cell phone, but you can call him anytime you want to. He said, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Amen? He don't have Facebook, but you can be his friend. He said he'll be a friend that sticketh closer than a brother. Amen? He don't have Twitter, but you can still follow him. He said, my sheep know my voice and they follow me. And I'm telling you tonight, you can serve God. You can live for God. You say it's too bad nowadays. You can live for God anywhere if you really want to. But you got to pay attention at church. You got to pay attention at church. You wouldn't listen when the preacher talked about Satan. The preacher told you about Satan and you thought it was a joke. You thought he's just a little cartoon character with a pitchfork and hollering boo at people, and that all of that stuff is biblically based, but that ain't all. The devil comes as an angel of light. The devil comes as a cool song or a pretty car or a woman or a man or a hat or money or some other form of temptation, alcohol. Like that. The devil's very smart, but you wouldn't listen when the preacher talked about Satan. Listen, brother, there's Satan movements all over this country. There's satanic activity going on. You saw it last night. It's everywhere. It's everywhere. And I'm telling you, you don't get a second chance at going to church. When you hear this sermon here tonight, you will never hear it again. You might hear it on a CD, but it will not be like you're getting it right now. You wouldn't listen when he talked about sin. You turned your back on God that gave you life and health. You determined to live like you please, like that girl there. You wouldn't listen when he talked about service. You just done what you wanted to do. I ain't gonna go no bus route. I wanna do what I wanna do. It's my life. That's what you hear now. It's my life. I'll do what I want to with it. Let me tell you something this evening. My life is not mine. It's his. He gave it to me. He can take it away anytime he wants to. You wouldn't listen. You wouldn't witness. You wouldn't visit. You wanted to flirt and play with the iPad and laugh during the invitation. I remember hearing preachers say, church service just like we're having here tonight in a little small country church. He said the preacher preached hard that night. And when the invitation came, he walked down the aisle. He said there was a young man he'd never seen before come sit in the back, had his arm around this girl. And the preacher said he felt a strange burden to go back and speak to that young man. He said he went back and he bent over like that and he said, son, I have a burden for you. Will you come and get saved? He said that boy looked at him and he said, look. He said, the only reason I'm here is to take this girl out to a dance tonight. As soon as we get out of here, that's where we're going. You can take your God and your Bible and you go on you know where with it. And that preacher turned around like that and said, I'll be praying for you. They sang a couple more verses and they dismissed. That young man was furious. He said, I can't believe that man come back here and embarrass me like this. I'm out of here. And as soon as they got through singing, he hit the front door of that church, that little church. You know, them little country churches have a little set of steps and a porch light out there. And he said, that boy took off down them steps like that. And there's a car. Somebody come down the road drunk, lost control of that car and come across that churchyard and run over that boy. And he never knew what hit him. He's gone. It's over. He never go to church again. He don't get a second chance. You don't get a second chance at church if you blow it. Don't get a second chance. Number four, you don't get a second chance for eternity. The people in Noah's day had 120 years to repent, and they wouldn't do it. The Bible said Noah's a preacher of righteousness, so we assume from that that Noah preached on a regular basis to warn people that the flood was coming. Some of you teenagers sitting here tonight have been warned and warned and warned and warned and warned. But you're still saying no. Still want to be cool. Still want to be friends with the popular kids at school. Hey, you better sit down and listen to me. You better hear me tonight. Oh, they said, the preacher said one time, there's a young man trying to get him to come to revival. And this girl had tried to get this boy to come to revival. He was 21 years old. He came on Tuesday or Wednesday night, and she said, please come back. Please. He said, I will. She said, will you promise me you'll come back before the week's out? He said, I promise you I'll come back the last night, Friday. They're going to have something special. And he promised her he'd be back on Saturday night or Friday night. Friday night came. Everybody come in. Everybody got their seats. Everybody sat down in the house of God. They sang. They fellowshipped. He wasn't there. And she looked and he wasn't there. She looked again and he wasn't there. Ladies and gentlemen, she looked, he didn't come. They didn't find him till 8 days later. He went fishing that night down at the lake instead of keeping his promise about church. And he decided to dive in, take a swim, and he dove in. And they got tangled up in some limbs, an old tree underneath that water, and they found his swelled up body, drowned 8 days later. And the last thing she heard him say was, I promise I'll be there. Friday night, y'all please pray, please. The people in Lot's day, the Bible said Lot vexed his righteous soul with their wicked deeds. And God said, get out. And God got Lot out. And then fire and brimstone came down. And they did not get a second chance. The rich man in Luke 16, he begged. He said, somebody come put water on my tongue. I'm in hell. I'm screaming. God help me. And he could not. You don't get to come back. You don't reincarnate. One chance. Only one chance. An 18-year-old boy was been in jail. The police told him, they said he'd be getting out this weekend. The preacher, he said, preacher, don't you come talk to him. He was rough. His daddy was a drunk. He'd been in trouble all over town, been locked up. Only 18 years of age. That boy talked to that preacher. He had a ponytail, an old dirty blue jeans on. And he told that preacher, witnessed to him. And he said, man, I can't get saved. He said, look at the mess I'm in. Look at the trouble I'm in. And the preacher said, the Lord can save you, buddy. The Lord can save you. And he said, I'll come. He came to the revival that night. And they said that he sat there and cried. Through the whole sermon, the preacher preached, sat there and cried. Finally, the preacher got through. He gave the invitation. Would you come? Would you come? And the young man would not come. He talked to him after church, and he said, son, I thought you was going to come. He said, I'm going to, preacher. And he said, will you come back Friday night? The boy came back Friday night. He came back that Friday night. He said, are you going to get saved? He said, I'm listening to you, preacher. I hear you. He got up and preached again. He preached again, and he preached hard. And he said, that young man sat there again. God was all over him. He said, everybody bow your head. When he did, he said, if you're not saved, raise your hand. He raised his hand. He said, would you come? Would you come? And he would not come. The boy would not come. He said he left him, went ahead and dismissed. And he said, friend, I can't understand that. He said, God's convicting you. God's dealing with you. Why don't you get saved? And he said, that young man looked and he said, preacher, I wasn't raised this way. He said, I got a lot to think about. He said, I'm going back home where I come from. He said, I'll let you know in 2 weeks. He said, in 2 weeks, you'll hear from me. He said, I want your address. Preacher, give him his address. He said, you'll hear from me in 2 weeks. He went on about it. Preacher said, I'll never hear from him again. Sure enough, 2 weeks went by. 2 weeks went by. Preacher got a letter. And he got this letter. And it was from a policeman. And the policeman said, I found your address. He said, we received a call to go down here at such and such. And he said, inside that envelope was some pictures. He said, we've took. It's an old, dilapidated, run-down trailer in a mobile home. He said, beer cans were stacked like pyramids on it. Around here and there, and there was marijuana laying on the table. The stove was just had old grime on it. You couldn't even tell what color that it was. He said another picture showed a .38 pistol and had one shot gone out of it. And then it showed the young man laying on the couch. Underneath his eye was a hole big enough you could stick your thumb in and out the back of his head. His buddy sitting across the room had got that .38 and shot him in the face. And there was his body stretched out on that couch. And they said this, young people. They got that guy that shot him and said, what in the world's wrong with you? He said, we're sitting here, there's all high. And he said, I saw him and it was the face of a demon. And he said, I pulled a gun out. And I said, I'm going to shoot that devil. And it was that boy, the devil was in his mind and making him see a demon. And he said, that boy threw up his hands like, no, don't shoot. And he said, it looked like claws coming at him. And he said, I pulled that trigger. And he said, that's the last I ever seen, heard of. And the guy said, the police said, why'd you do that? He said, I thought I was shooting the devil. He said, I didn't know what I was doing was wrong. That boy told that preacher, in 2 weeks you'll hear from me. But he never did. It was the other guy who took him out of this world. Tonight, that party they were planning on going to, they went. Let's see them at the party.
Get crazy, get wild, let's party, get loud. If you wanna have fun, then do something. If you wanna have fun, then do something. Get crazy.
Eyebrows on fleek. Wait, well, totally posting that on Instagram.
Oh, yeah.
This party is so ratchet. Let's go take a ride in Daddy's sports car.
Yeah, let's go. I mean, we're only young once. We might as well live it up. Let's go. Let's get out of here.
That's what they did, young people. What they didn't know is when they took that ride in that sports car, they never made it home. Never did make it home. And the truth is, tonight, this is Saturday night, And there'll be teenagers in this state tonight that go take daddy's car and drive down the road and don't never come back home. It happens every single weekend. You don't get a second chance. You don't get to come back. You don't get to say, wait a minute, God, I made a mistake. It's over. It's over. Have you ever thought about what it would be like? I used to lay around and think about that, what it would be like to be in a really, really terrible car accident. And I thought, I wonder, you know, I've been in little wrecks, little bang-ups here and there, but never nothing serious. And I've always wondered, you know, that last split second right before you hit. It's like it's a half of a split second, and you know you're done. And it happens every single week to some teenager. What they didn't know, young people, was that coming around the curve was another vehicle. You ever wondered what it was like? Okay, Brian. I wonder if you've ever seen what it was like. You don't know. See, you don't know what's going to happen on the way home. No second chance after you're gone. You hear me? No second chance. I don't care who's your boyfriend. I don't care who your daddy is. I don't care how much money you got. He may be the president or he may be the governor. You don't get to come back and try it again. One shot, buddy. One shot. You leave here tonight not saved. This happens all the time. Watch it. That last second. What you're going to see is kids getting killed. There it was. Every minute, some teenager goes to hell and you don't get out. That's why we pray. That's why we preach. That's why we beg God to get a hold of your heart here tonight. It's not a joke. You don't get a second chance. It's time to pray, folks. It's time to pray. There's no mercy in hell. Thousands of young people are falling into eternity without God and don't ever get out. They don't ever get a second chance. They don't ever get out. You say, preacher, is that true? That's what that Bible said. And if a man's preaching the Bible, he'll tell you that's the truth. No second chance after you die. That is the way it looks. You want to know what it looks like? Watch this. You can hear this boy scream right before he dies. Watch it right here. Here he goes. Watch. People tonight out there drinking and smoking pot and saying, yeah, we're invincible. And then it's too late and the devil laughs at you forever and ever and ever and ever. You say, I'm a good driver. Hey, it don't matter how good a driver you are when this happens. That's real. That's not fake. Don't die in your sin, kid. You only get one chance. You don't get to come back and say, Mommy, I love you. You don't get to come back and apologize to your parents. When they're gone or you're gone, that's it. No second chance, friend. You don't get to come back. You don't get to come back and say, I'll go to the altar. I'll go to the altar and get right, preacher. I just need another chance. Just give me one more chance. You don't get another chance. That's it. No second chance after you die. You listening to me tonight? I'm going to have that same spirit we had here last night. And it's a different spirit than you feel out of this. It's a spirit in which you say, God, I want you to work in my life. Go ahead. You let God speak to your heart. Every head bowed, every eye closed. You let God speak to your heart. You let God speak to your heart. I want you right now, if you don't know for a fact you're saved, if you don't know for a fact you're born again, I want you to get out of your seat, get in this altar, because you don't get a second chance. If you're here tonight and you've never been saved, come on. If you're here tonight and you have been saved, but you ain't been living right, come on, girl, turn that up, please. Amen, let's go. You let God speak to your heart. Come on, kids. We need a bunch of soul winners. We need a bunch of soul winners. Give me some volume. You let God speak to your heart. 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 Come on. Come on. We need soul winners. Come on. Come on. Turn that up, please. Let God speak to your heart. Amen. You let God help you this evening. Yes. Let God speak to your heart. Come on. Come on, kids. Come on. We need some soul winners up here tonight. We need some soul winners. That's right. Let God speak to your heart tonight. Come on, let's go. Come on, kid. Let's go. Come on, mamas and daddies. Let's get in this altar tonight. Mamas and daddies weeping, getting their heart right. We need some parents here tonight. Say, I'm going to get back to the Bible. I'm going to raise my kids right. I'm going to teach them to serve God. I'm going to take them to Sunday school. I'm going to take them to preaching service. You come on right now. Come on, mama. Come on, daddy. Come on back there in the back. Come on right now. Amen. Amen. Come on. Amen. Come on, kids. You let the Lord help you tonight. Come on, boys and girls. Amen. Yeah. Y'all just stay up here now. Keep them up here. We're going to pray with them. Keep them up here. You keep them up here, soul winners. Amen. 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 You let the Lord help you tonight. Come on, mama. Come on tonight, mama. Come on, daddy. Come on, young teenager. Come on, boys. Keep them up here, y'all. Keep them up here. We're going to pray with them. This boy got saved. Amen. Ain't a lot getting saved here tonight. Y'all stay up here now. Stay up here. Stay up here. Stay up here. Keep them up here tonight. Amen. Come on tonight. Maybe you've never been to the altar in your life. You need to come. Come on. Come on, girl. Don't you be ashamed. Don't you be embarrassed. You come on right now. Come on. Come on. Get up. Come right now. Get up. Come right now. You know you need to do something right. You know you need to get right with God. You come on right now. Hey, man. Come on. Get up. Get up. Come. Get up. Come right now. Come on. Just keep them up here, y'all. Y'all keep them up here. Y'all stay up here. Amen. Amen. Here comes some more over here. Y'all pray with these coming over here. Let God speak your heart. Come on. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Stay up here, y'all. Keep them up here. We're going to pray with them. That's right. Come on tonight, girl. Come on, teenagers. You know what you need to do. Come on. Come on right now. Amen. Some of you sitting back there, God's speaking to your heart. You know what you need to do. Come on. Come on right now. Come on. Come on right now. Come on right now. Come on, right now. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. God's still on the throne. Amen. Amen. That boy got saved. That boy got saved. Amen. Hallelujah. Woo! Yeah. Y'all stay up here now. We're going to pray with you. Stay up here. We're going to pray with you. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Yes. Hallelujah. Boy, that nerve's getting the old God there, boy. Amen. That's the way you like to see it right there, boy. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, that's our heart's desire. See God get a hold of somebody's heart. Hit me. Yes, hallelujah. Hit me. Lord of God. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank the Lord. Hit. Hallelujah. Hit. Amen. 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 Stay up here, y'all. We're going to pray with you. Just stay right where you're at. We're going to pray with you. Amen. Amen. Maybe there's somebody else. I'm going to get you to come back up here, so you might as well stay up here. Amen. Amen. All right. Some still praying up here tonight. If you're here tonight, if you've been to the altar, get back up here. Come on, stay up, get up here. If God done something for you, come up here and got help from the Lord, you got saved, you got right. Come back up here. Okay, Chris. All right. Come on. If you got saved or got right with God, come back up here and get across the front here. Line all the way to the wall over there. All the way to the wall. All the way to that wall. Yeah, man. Man, they're about four deep right here. Isn't that a blessing? Come on. Come on, y'all, scoot over this way a little bit so they can get up here. Hit. Well, glory to God. Come up here, big boy. See this big boy right here? How old are you?
I'm 17, sir.
17. Sound like a Marine there, didn't he? Hear that? Boy just got called to preach. The Lord called him to preach. Let's give the Lord a big amen. Amen. Stay up here. That's a real man there, buddy. Hey, it takes some guts for a man to stand up in this generation and say, I'm going to be a preacher. You know you can get your head cut off for doing what I did tonight, don't you? I ain't trying to sound tough. I'm scared. I ain't wanting no persecution. But you know this is the risk we take. And these people around in this country, they'd kill me right now if they'd get away with it. Only thing's protecting me is God. And buddy, you pray for this boy. He can knock him out. Amen? 17. I was 19, so you got to jump on me. You ought to be doing real good real soon. Ain't you glad this young man got enough guts to do what God wants him to do? Amen. You know what Paul told Timothy? He said, you know what Paul told Timothy? He said, be a good soldier of Jesus Christ. If you don't think it takes a soldier, you ought to try it. All you young men, if God's called you to preach, get up and preach, buddy. Get up and preach. Don't make no apology for what that book says. All right. All right. How many tonight you just got saved? You got saved this evening in the evening service, or you got saved tonight? Would you raise your hand, please? Raise it and hold it up now till I get through counting. Hold it up now till I get through counting. You just got saved. That was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. 25, that's 31. Any more? Back there. Anybody back there? We got somebody just got saved. There's 32, 33, 34. That's at least 34 we counted here tonight. Isn't that a blessing? Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. And all you other 75 have just come to rededicate your life and get right with God. This meeting's pretty hardcore, and you know why? Because we're living in an extreme time. And extreme times calls for extreme preaching. This little sermonette stuff ain't gonna cut it this generation. We gotta hit them right between the eyes with the truth of God. Amen. All right, Brian, give me another light. Another light. Well, y'all stay up here. We're going to pray with you. And then we're going to, I know that by way of announcements, everybody be quiet just a second. All right. We don't have a nursery, so appreciate mamas. You just done the best you could, which wasn't really that great, but I think you could have done better, but I do appreciate your effort. Sorry we don't have a nursery here. Maybe we can rig up something for next time. But we're going to get some motor oil and pull and get them demons out of that wall too if we do this again next year. Now listen, some of these folks got a long way to go and they're going to be loading up. But we expecting all y'all to eat.